spring day. We are pleased, so pleased to be here back in Gay Cottage, one of the most special meeting places we have in our community. And especially excited because we have some brand new scissors to use for the ribbon cutting today. I thought about that this morning. I was like, oh man, how perfect. Who got these brand new scissors for the brand new Gay Cottage? But Gay Cottage is so important to so many people for so many reasons. And it is known as the meeting place for many of our nonprofits and many of our special occasions, ceremonies, and special parties. And so I want to turn it over to Dr. Gardner, who's a great community partner. He serves on our board, the Chamber of Commerce, and we are so thankful that he is such a great community partner. I'd like to turn it over to him to let us tell us a few words about the construction and reconstruction and reopening of the facility. Thank you.
I want to just say about 4 minutes worth. It was a cold, snowy morning in northern Indiana when on January 12th, when I was awakened by a phone call at 3:25. And I looked at that phone and it said Alan Coker. And I said, this can't be good. So that Gay Cottage was on fire. Gay Cottage would be lost. I made my way back with 6 inches of snow on those back roads to get out to the interstate, back to Indianapolis, and then flew to Atlanta, and by 6 o'clock, I was standing out front, seeing the smoke and what was left of Gay Cottage. My eyes were filled with tears because of my history in this building, as well as a student, as well as a vice president for advancement when my offices were upstairs. I understood how important this structure was to the citizens of Stevens County. It is not just a part of the history of Toccoa Falls College. It is part of the history of this community. And on Thursday, January 15th, 2009, the Toccoa Record put out these headlines: "We will rebuild." And I understood that we were going to rebuild, that it was a story about the past, but it was also a story about the future. It was a promise to the leadership of this college that we would rebuild, and it was made to the people of Toccoa and of Stevens County. And I read the editorial that day, and the last paragraph that Tom Law wrote said, "We are looking forward to the day when we round the last bend on Forest Drive on the TFC campus, and we will see the shape of the new Gay Cottage in its familiar location alongside the rushing waters of Toccoa Creek." That is exactly what is happening today. Gay Cottage has been rebuilt, it's complete, and we have many to thank, but I want to first thank especially Alan Coker, Jerry Williamson, and the college maintenance staff that worked tirelessly to clean up the burned out building and to assist in the rebuilding. We're grateful for Payne Construction, Lynn Payne, the owner, and all the local subcontractors. And there's a list of them up here. Two were from Habersham County and the rest were from Stevens County that built this building and the building over there. So that was about $1.7 million back in into the community. The Arts and Sciences building is now being used. It's being used and it's being inhabited by our Arts and Sciences counseling staff and students this summer for summer school as well. Aramark Regional Manager Jeff Hall, you know Matt Steele, who is our food service director, and then Missy Luttrell, also from the Aramark office, has also played a great part in the progress of this building. And as of today, the new Gay Cottage is available both for private and public catering. We're glad to again be able to serve the community and the businesses with any catered food event that you might need. The Gay Cottage's Sunday brunch will return soon. We've still got a little bit more that we need to do. But But we thank the Lord for his provision and for this building that will again serve the Toccoa Stevens County community. I've asked Mr. Alan Coker to just lead us in a word of prayer for of thanks to God for this that he has provided.
Thank you. Let us pray together. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the beauty of this day and the beauty of this time that we can gather here. And Father, just fall down before your throne and thank you. Thank you for your provision. You are the God that provides. Father, we thank you that out of the ashes that you've given us beauty. Father, it is our prayer right now that you will look upon this building, that you'll use it to your glory. Father, may it be a blessing to us here on campus and to this great community of Toccoa and Stevens County that we live in. May this building just cry out your name. Father, we just pray that you'll look down upon it, that you'll bless it. It'll be used for your glory. And it's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen. Anytime you're ready.
Okay, we ready? Three.
Oh, now.
Two.
I thought you were counting down.
Okay. I did too.
Two and one.